Assalamu alaikum students. Today we will study about indefinite pronouns. So grade 4 indefinite pronouns. We use indefinite pronouns to refer to people or things that are not specific, that indicate the entire noun or some of the noun or none of the noun. We use when we want to refer to groups of noun without actually specifying who or how much. So here are the list for indefinite pronoun, that is somebody, somewhere, anything, no one, everybody, everywhere, someone, anybody, anywhere, nothing, everyone, few, something, anyone, nobody, nowhere, everything, many. Okay, the words which carry the which has body or someone. These indefinite pronouns are used for the pupil, and the words which is carrying the word thing, few, indefinite pronouns are used for the name for the things. Here are some example, and it will help you to understand the concept well. Number one, it is hard to say somebody is good, but still nobody can replace. Sometime I just need someone to talk to. It is easy to learn something about everything, but difficult to learn everything about anything. We need to find somewhere to live. We should not fight anybody, even if he is a nobody. It was patent to anybody that she disliked the idea. If anything can go wrong, it will. I have lost my keys. I can't find them anywhere. Everyone wants to be a hero, but no one wants to die. The frog in well knows nothing of the great ocean. The house was nowhere near the sea. Everybody should be made aware of the risks. His children go everywhere with him. So now here is the page 145, and the 145 is the indefinite pronoun, and there is also a list of indefinite pronoun: no one, anyone, someone, everyone, nobody, anybody, somebody, everybody, nothing, anything, something, and everything. Some few examples are: everyone sang and danced to celebrate the completion of the well. Anybody wants to help, look after baby brother, ask mom. Nothing is impossible. We just have to work hard to achieve our dreams, declared Ryan. Now fill in the blanks with indefinite pronoun from the list above. Do not fret, everything is taken care of. Dash has to stay behind to help clean up the classroom. Someone has to stay behind to help clean up the classroom. Number third one is, I'm going out for lunch. Would you like dash from the restaurant? Would you like anything from the restaurant? As soon as the concert was over, everybody left the hall quietly. Number five, Dash wants to be late for the movie. Nobody wants to be late for the movie. From there, we are open page number 146, which says we use a singular verb immediately after an indefinite pronoun. Mr. Lee is a fantastic teacher. Everyone loves her. Nobody likes to play with Sally because she is always complaining. Something is wrong with the machine. Please call the mechanic. We usually use a plural pronoun when we refer back to an indefinite pronoun. We need to drive somebody to the hospital first. They cannot wait for a long period of time. Nobody wants to join us for dinner because they have to pay a huge amount of money for it. Everyone gave generously to the buildings of Rayan's well because they were touched by his wish to help people he didn't know. Now fill in the blanks with correct plural pronoun or singular verb. The man can start building well because everything is ready. Because everything is ready. Somebody forgot to lock the door because they left in a great hurry. Nobody wants to eat chocolate. They want to eat ice cream. Everyone is at home today. Now we have a spelling, that is we double the T for the verb of more than one syllable when the stress is on the last syllable. That is forgot, forgotten. Regret, regretted. Submit, submitted. Now you people have to repeat after me. Forgotten, permitted, admitted, transmitted, regretted, committed, allotted, bitten, submitting, inputting. Now fill in the blanks with the word from the words list above. Have you dared to bring your lunch to school today? Have you forgotten to bring your lunch to school today? He was put in jail because he had committed a crime. We were dashed to park our car inside the building because we were special guests. We were allotted to park. We were permitted to park our car inside the building because we were special guests. The hiker was dashed by a rattlesnake. The hiker was bitten by rattlesnake. Many diseases can be dashed through water. Many diseases can be transmitted through water. They were late in dash their work in submitting their work. They were late in submitting their work. After Ray fought with his mother, he dashed it. He regretted it. Now we are doing some speaking activity. How do you express thanks? Here are some words you could use while expressing thanks. Thank you very much for raising money to build the well for us. We really appreciate what you have done for us. Now we can have clean water easily. You are most welcome. You are welcome. I hope you like it. Thank you for the lovely birthday present. Now, there is a writing section 150. How would you write a headline and introductory paragraph of a newspaper report? Here are few things you should keep in mind. Newspaper headlines are usually catchy and attention grabbing. The introductory paragraph usually answers the questions who, what, where, when. The notes below are written by a reporter from the Daily Express. Using the notes, write a headline and introductory paragraph about the event in your notebook. So the first point is 10-year-old girl Mary Yolanda. 18 December 2011, they were united. Family was separated during the 2004 tsunami that hit the coast of Aceh province. Mary was saved from the flood and sent to an orphanage. Her picture was taken by a charity organization that tries to help reunite families separated by natural disaster. The organization posted the picture in community places and on the internet. Her parents recognized her from her first name and distinctive mole and birthmark on her face. After 7 years of separation, they went to orphanage to be reunited with half. So what would be the heading? Heading would be parents and children reunited after 7 years of separation. So this can be the heading, and after that you can write all these details in a paragraph. Okay, in my class I will show you how to write this paragraph. Okay dear, that's all for today. Thank you. Till next class, Allah Hafiz.